thought was going to happen at 7 o'clock.
Well, I'm not entirely sure what happened. We have not been in direct communication with Brookfield regarding it. But we got the message at 6:15 this morning that the deputy mayor had postponed the order to do the cleaning and that Brookfield had withdrawn their request to do it. So it seems to me that the political momentum of having politicians, councilmen, unions, community groups put pressure on the city and contact Brookfield, and the numbers that we had more than 1,000 people out at 6 a.m., shows that we're a legitimate movement and that we have a right to be here and protest peacefully.
The mayor this morning on the radio was talking about how there were a great deal of politicians who kind of like intervened and tried to negotiate these things, people like Scott Stringer, de Blasio, Quinn, Dan Squadron, whose district this is in. What kind of difference is that making, though, to have those people who do have some power in this city on your side?
Well, it makes a big difference because clearly their voice matters. And when the decision's being taken into account, the political repercussions are very important. Not only the fact that we have people out here, but that we have people in powers of government that can do something to us. So clearly it had an effect.
I get the impression that there are a lot of people maybe out there not directly involved in this or looking at this going, why are these politicians siding with these, you know, grungy kids down there?
Of course, right.
What do you say to people who think that? And obviously, there are some people who are siding with you in positions of power.
There are. Well, I think our message is really resonating with a wide sector of American public opinion. If you keep looking at the poll numbers, our favorability rating continues to climb. We have a higher favorability rating than Congress. And I think it really shows that our message about economic justice and democracy is spreading across the country and should be taken seriously.
But if the police had come down here with firearms and everything, it would have looked bad.
It would have looked bad if they had forcibly pushed everyone out of the park at once. And given the fact that previous events, such as the pepper spraying of two women on the side of the street, really rallied the movement and gave the press a lot to work with regarding the police, you know, it shows that repression doesn't work, and we're not trying to push a society of violence. We're trying to be peaceful protesters and trying to get our message out.
Can you throw a bone to the mayor, though? I mean, do you see him as the enemy here, or is he trying to work out something or not?
This morning, we got the word that we can have our protest continue. As long as we can have our protest continue, things are fine. We just want to be respected in our right to protest.
But did this morning just delay the inevitable? That eventually, in a couple days, they're going to come back down?
Frankly, I don't know what's going to happen from here. But my hope is that this has shown that the way to solve this is through negotiation and through some sort of a common understanding that respects our right to protest and also respects the wishes of the city.